Excuse me, can somebody give me a cue there, please?
Okay. Hey, Ingo. Sorry to interrupt, but it's time for
5 minutes with Ingo.
5 minutes with Ingo.
Excellent. Cool. So today, since I'm in Germany, I will probably make a little bit shorter topic, and this one is going to be a small trick every practitioner should really be aware of, because it's very helpful in practice to improve the prediction accuracy of your models. So before I'm getting there, I need to show and explain something to you. And I've been drawing this here on this piece of paper. So what you can see here is really like the different areas for predictions. So we have a decision boundary here in the middle, and the further we are away from this decision boundary, the more sure we are that the prediction is correct. So those plus cases here, we are pretty confident that those cases are really positive. So we say we have 100% confidence, and that is this quarter here. But if you get closer to the decision boundary, the level of confidence goes actually down. And in those cases here, where we only have a confidence of 50%, like in this quarter, we can only expect that we only get 50% of all the cases right. And the same is true on the negative side. Okay? So that's this concept of confidence, and that's very useful in predictions in general. Usually you're not just saying like, okay, this is a positive case or this is a negative case. You're also interested in understanding how sure is the machine learning model actually that this case is really positive or really negative, and the confidence can help you with this. But there's another thing you can do, and I promised you a small trick to actually improve your prediction accuracy, because let's think about this. If you look at this picture again, so here we have our bar from before, and if you look at all the cases, then in all cases we are only correct in 75%. So that means that in 25%, all those cases in the center here where we are less sure, we are not correct. So the big question is, what can we do about this? And that's now the small, neat little trick. All right, so we could only focus on those quarters which are further away from the decision boundary. So we only take those two here and we just remove all the cases where the confidence is not high enough. And if we do this, we only cover 50%, those 25 and those 25% of the complete possible data set. So, but in those 50% we do cover here, we are correct in 100% of the cases. So instead of looking at all the data points and then we end up being correct in only 75% of the cases, we now look at 50% of the data points, but we are always correct, or, well, as good as we can be. And so why is this important? Because often machine learning models that are used to, well, replace a human decision making. That means that you can actually now automate those decisions for cases where you're 100% sure, and then the machine can make the decision and can act on that. And in all other cases where the confidence is not high enough, those 50% where the machine learning method is saying like, maybe not, I'm not sure enough, those are the cases which you can still manually work on. So you reduce your manual work by 50%, and that's often a big gain, because those are also typically the cases where human interaction is not really necessary, because they are more the clear cases. And then you can give the less clear cases to a human being for the final decision, and save some work with that. And that's actually the small trick for today. Remove uncertain predictions.
And this has been your 5 minutes with Ingo.
Okay, that's good enough for me.
Yeah. come on, I'm gonna do it again. Hear me out, terrified, sun and
right. So I'm looking like a pirate now.
Yes, exactly.
Yeah.